Hello again and welcome. Thank you for joining me. Today I thought I'd do a short video about a real simple, easy to make ham radio antenna. This is a dual band 2 meter and 70 centimeter vertical dipole antenna. And this is real simple, easy to make, costs very little. I've made this one out of plexiglass and 1/8 inch stainless steel rod. Actually, I made this antenna about 10 years ago. And I let another ham use this antenna. He had it up on his rooftop for about 9 or 10 years until he became a silent key this past summer. And so I had to go over and take the antenna down. But really, I was very surprised at how good a shape this antenna was still in after being up on the rooftop for so long, almost a decade. And when I took it down, I really expected the plexiglass to have turned yellow. And I was really surprised that it's really mostly clear. Since I use stainless steel hardware on the feed point and use coaxial seal, everything came down looking just like it did the day that it was installed. It shows very little wear. The only thing, I've got a little bit of rust on a U-bolt here that's holding the coaxial cable. But it's a real simple, easy to make antenna. This is plexiglass and 1/8 inch stainless steel rod. And let me explain how this was mounted on the rooftop. This was mounted on a section of mast that is 4 feet long, and we used a vent pipe mount to mount the antenna on the rooftop with. And so this was just mounted on a vent pipe. It didn't have any guy wires on it. And really, guys, if you go any higher than or any taller than a 4 foot mast, then you probably might want to put some guy wires on it too. The vent pipe has a little bit of give in the roof. And so there is a little bit of play. This did have some extra tar put around the shingles, around the vent pipe after a little bit of a time. So other than that, just a little bit of wind vibration, it really held up very well. And so this antenna has really been put to the test. And let me lay this out on the table here, and so you can see how this is put together, and I'll give you all the measurements for it. Okay guys, I'm a couple of steps ahead here. I've decided to go ahead and take apart the antenna. I think that'll be the simplest and easiest way for me to show you how to put this together. I started out with a piece of plexiglass that is, this is 1/4 inch thick, or 7 millimeters, and it is 18 inches long by 2.5 inches wide. That's about 45.7 centimeters by 6.4 centimeters. The stainless steel elements, this is 1/8 inch stainless steel rod, and you'll need two pieces that are about 30 to 36 inches long. Now for the mounting hardware, at the time I mostly had just some number 6 hardware, and I decided to use that. And what I used was two number 6 machine screws that are 1 inch long. It's a number 6 by 32 by 1, or about 24 or 25 millimeters long. These are two 6x32 wing nuts. I've got two number 6 split washers, two number 6 flat washers, and also I'm going to add to this antenna two number 6 external tooth lock washers. The larger washers, I ended up using 4 1/4 inch washers, and they needed to be long enough so that they fit across the element and go all the way across both sides of it. Now, if I had had some larger mounting hardware, I would have used an 8 or a 10 or something a little bit bigger, since I really needed some larger washers. But this is how I ended up putting it together. And if you use some larger hardware, you can probably skip these two washers here. We just need that for the gap in these big washers. The end of the coaxial cable, I've got two number 6 ring connectors, one red one, one blue one, with the insulation taken off, and those have been attached to the coaxial cable. And when you do your cable, you want to keep your leads as short as possible. Also, I have a little U-bolt here and a couple of nuts, and actually I just robbed those out of a wire rope clip. And this little U-bolt is just used to fasten the coaxial cable to the end of my boom, so that so that my coaxial cable stays out at a 90 degree angle from the feed point. You're also going to need a mast mounting clamp. And by the way, if you don't have a little U-bolt like that, you can use a plastic cable tie. That'll work just fine. And in the acrylic boom here, I've got two holes drilled at this end for the antenna elements. On the other hand here, I've got two holes drilled for my mounting clamp, and then also for my little U-bolt down here to hold my coaxial cable on. Now, for the antenna elements, I came in 1/2 inch from the edge, or about 13 millimeters, and on the bottom and top edges, I came in about 3/8 inch, or about 10 millimeters. My holes aren't exactly perfect here, but it's pretty close. The space in between the two holes is about 1 3/4 inches, or about 44 millimeters between the two holes there, from center to center of the two holes. For the mast mounting clamp, it depends on what you're going to use. This is for a TV antenna mast, and you'll just lay that on your plastic and drill a couple holes for your mounting clamp or your U-bolt or whatever you're using. I came up 7/8 inch, or about 22 millimeters, and drilled the holes for the mounting bracket. Now the two holes here for the cable, I've just kind of centered the cable in the plastic and kind of judged where to drill a couple of holes. Those are 2 3/16 inch holes that are just to hold the coaxial cable on the boom. Okay, so we start off with two pieces of 1/8 inch stainless steel rod that's about 30 to 36 inches long. And here's what I did to get this bend. I took a piece of stainless steel rod, and what you're going to do is measure out a little bit longer than what the 70 centimeter length is going to be, and come up a couple of inches. So you'll be 8 or 9 inches from the end of it here, and then start your bend in the stainless steel rod. Now this is a little bit tough to bend. What I did was I stuck it in a bench vise one way and got the bend started, and then I took it out and stuck the little short side of the stainless steel in the bench vise like that, and then just completed the fold, just continued folding it over. So just stick it in there like that, and get it started, and then stick it in there like that, and finish bending it. Now after you have your bend made in your wire, then you can trim it off to the correct length. And so you want to make this length and this length a little bit longer, and then trim it. And so you'll measure from the very bottom edge of the element out towards the end, and the 2 meter length is 18 5/8 inch long, and that's measuring with a tape measure from the very bottom edge here out towards the end of the element, and that's about 47.3 centimeters, 18 5/8 inches. And the shorter side, the 70 centimeter element, you'll make that 6 1/4 inches long, or about 15.9 centimeters. And then the gap in between the two elements should be about 9 to 10 millimeters apart, center to center, about 3/8 inch. And so that's it. That's very simple. They're really not that difficult to make. The tricky part is just trying to get two folds that look pretty much the same. But if you just stick that in the bench vise, you'll have a lot better luck trying to bend those. Now to put this together, we'll start with a machine screw and the external tooth lock washer, and we'll slip the lock washer on the machine screw first, and then put that through our plastic. Take the other side, put that in there too. And then we're going to use 2 1/4 inch flat washers. Put those on there, just like that. And then our elements go on. And you can position them either way, either with the elements going this way or this way, that's up to you. I'm going to put them on the outside like that. Just lay those on there. And we take 2 more of those larger washers. And then I'm having to use the smaller number 6 washers because of the size difference there in the washers I'm using. Just take that out so I can see them. Like that. The next step is to take and attach coaxial cable. And let's see here. This is going to be the top of the antenna. This is going to be the bottom of the antenna. So we put the center lead on the top section, and the shield on the bottom section, like that. And I've got the two lock washers. Put the lock washers down on there. Two wing nuts. Okay, and so when we've got the antenna elements on there, we're ready to tune the antenna. To tune it for the best SWRs, all we simply do is loosen a wing nut and slide the element either in or out between those lock washers, or between those flat washers, and just slide the element in or out. Now what you do to one side, you should do to the other side. You want to keep the two halves of the dipole equal. So if that sticks out a little bit like that, we'll make the other one stick out like that. And if you'd like to, you can use a tape measure and measure it. Now you shouldn't have to do any extra trimming to this antenna. You can if you like. If you want to do a little bit of fine tuning, you can trim just a little bit more off of the 70 centimeter band or the 2 meter length, either one. But you shouldn't really have to. And of course, whenever you shorten, let's say when you're tuning the antenna, let's say you want to shorten the 2 meter length, remember you're also shortening the 70 centimeter length. And so any changes to the SWR by adjusting the length of the antenna, when you do that, you're going to be adjusting both bands. And so you just have to find just a kind of a happy medium between between the two bands. Well, with the other end of our plexiglass boom, take our coaxial cable and stretch it out. And put our little U-bolt in there. Hold that in place. And put the nuts on it. And then you'll take the mounting clamp and you'll put that on the opposite side of the boom. Up there like that. Put a little hardware on it. There's a couple of flat washers and a couple of lock washers. Nuts on there. And that's it for the other side. Okay, I've got the antenna set back up on my other little table stand. And there it is all put together, and we'll check the SWRs. Okay, I can check the 2 meter band, but I can't check 70 centimeters. With the antenna analyzer, I'll have to use an SWR meter. This doesn't work on 70 centimeters. Where are we at here? 140.6, 0.7, 1.5. It's 1.0 at 146. 1.1 at 145.6. 144.9, it's 1.1. megahertz, it's 1.2. We'll go up the top edge of the band. Let's see, 149 megahertz, 1.1. And 1.0 at 148 megahertz. And I can go all the way down to 146 megahertz and it's still 1.0. So there's 146 megahertz. I've got a 1.0 SWR resistance or impedance here or here, 51 ohms, and so that's not too bad. Now I have my HT connected to a VHF UHF SWR meter, and let's see, I'm on 2 meters, I'm on 146.400. Let's key it up, and if you can see it there on the meter, it says I'm only doing about 3 watts forward, and the reflected meter just kind of barely moves, so it's showing I've got a near perfect SWR match there on 2 meters. Now, let's change bands. Okay, I am at 444.800. And it shows about 2 watts forward. And again, it just no reflected power there at all. It's 1.0 to 1.1. But there you see it. And that's checking the SWRs indoors. Well, that's it for now, guys. 7-3, and I'll see you later down the log. From KG0ZZ.